Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Averie, and here are some hate to love romance recommendations. This could also be considered enemies to lovers, hate to love. I'm more like the term hate to love instead of enemies to lovers, because some of these aren't like true enemies, if that makes sense. In these books, either both of the people in the couple hate or dislike each other, or just one person dislikes the other person. Because sometimes there's only one point of view, so you don't really know what the other person is feeling, if that makes sense. So some of these may or may not be like whole hate to love, hate you books, but there's definitely a dislike at the beginning. So mainly this book video is starts out with characters who do not like each other, and then they do. So I'm gonna show you those books now. First, we obviously have to go with the most popular out of the bunch, which is The Hating Game by Sally Thorne. This is a very, very well-beloved book on BookTube, but this book is about Lucy and Joshua, and they are both working for the same company, I'm pretty sure, and there is a promotion coming up, and they both want that promotion, and they have hated each other while working at this company, and like they banter all the time. It is so cute how you see their relationship and their like feelings change. I specifically think only Lucy. I don't know if we have Joshua's chapters. I don't think so. But we see Lucy's like feelings change from hate to love, and like, y'all, this is true. This book is true hate to love. She hates him at the beginning. And then like I love how you see like the change. That's what I love about most of these books, is I love how you can see the gradual change and like their viewpoint of this person change. And I love that. If a book has hate to love in it and I don't like it, it's because I was not able to see that change perfectly on page. And if I don't see the change, the gradual slow change, it's not a true hate to love for me, if that makes sense. It could be considered hate to love, but like if I don't feel those feelings of like someone changing their mind about somebody, like what's the point? So I feel like we got that in this book. Like we got like the feelings, we got the slow burn, we got just like the angst in here. I really like this one. It has a great caretaking scene. If you love books that have caretaking scenes in them, this book is it. There's actually a movie coming out very soon, and I'm very excited for it. Then I have Bitter Rival by Jay Sterling. This is a Romeo and Juliet-esque romance. It's not a retelling, it's esque, because this romance is between a son and a daughter from rivaling families. The daughter and the son, they're both from families who own winery companies, winery businesses, and winery farms. And their winery farms are right next door to each other. And so they've grown up knowing about the other person, but their parents have told them their whole lives, don't hang out with that person. No. Like they are rivals, hate each other, don't want their kids mixing at all. This book starts out with them when they're adults. Both can't stand one another. He more so dislikes her because he thinks that she rejected him in the past, and he doesn't care about the family rivalry. He thinks that she rejected him in the past, and she just doesn't want to be with him and hates him because of what her father has said about his family. It's quite an interesting dynamic. Their romance is forbidden once it happens, and I really enjoyed this one. It's kind of like Romeo and Juliet-esque because they have to hide from their families and keep this relationship secret. At the beginning, you can see them totally disliking one another. But again, you see that gradual change shift for that. Then I have A Beach Read by Emily Henry. Now, I know that some people do not consider this book a romance, and I get that. I consider it a romance, kind of, just because the romance in here was a major plot in here, but to some people, it wasn't the main plot. And in romance books, the romance part is the main plot. And I totally get that. I totally get that. But the romance in here, I really liked it. So this is about January, and she was going through some rough things with her family, and her dad just recently passed, and she learned some shocking news about her father after he's already passed. And she goes to stay at this lake house that her father has. And in the house right next to hers is Gus. And Gus used to be her college rival. So January has some very, very angsty and harboring ill feelings towards Gus because of the things that he put her through in college. And like, she just can't stand him. We don't have Gus's point of view in here, and so you can't really know what he thinks in here. But I think it's just one-sided here. I think only January has those feelings. But Gus is very gruff and standoffish at the beginning. Like, he seems like he doesn't really like her. So it kind of like seems that way. but both of them don't like each other. But I just love the dynamic in here, again, of the changing from hate to love. And I really liked how these characters like grew in their friendship and learned how to like get to know one another. I loved how they got to know one another in this book and how they were really vulnerable with one another. I love when characters are vulnerable. I love it so much. Then we have Punk 57 by Penelope Douglas. This one could also fall into the trope of childhood friends to enemies to lovers. This book is about, I can't remember the names at the moment. One of them's named Misha, I think. but this is about a guy and a girl, and when they were kids, they went to different schools, and they were in like a pen palling system thing between their schools, and they got assigned to be pen pals with one another, and they grew up their whole lives throughout high, all the way up into high school, being pen pals and writing to one another, and they both pictured what this person would be like in person, but they have made a promise never to look the other person up, never to look them up on the internet, just leave it be, just only have a relationship through these letters, until something happens to Misha to where he does not write our heroine for I believe a year or more, and our heroine has no idea why she's still sending these letters, and he won't respond. Then one day a new kid comes to our heroine's school, high school, this is a high school romance by the way, and it may or may not be the boy that she has been writing letters to her whole life, and he may or may not hate her because she is the complete opposite of the person she presented herself in those letters. Like, she is a judgmental, rude cheerleader in real life, and that is not what he expected this girl to be like, and he is quite mad, and he kind of takes it out on her, and she has no idea that that is the same person. Like, she has no idea that that's Misha in real life. Like, no idea. Because of the things that Misha is doing to her, she learns to hate him. So this one is a true hate to love, enemies to lovers in here, that I found highly entertaining. Then we have Toxic Desire by Robin Lovett. This is an alien romance book, and these two are enemies, like full-on enemies, because their humanoid species are at war with each other. She is a part of the humans, and he is a part of this alien race that I don't know or could even pronounce the name of, but he basically like has gold skin all over him and he has fangs and everything. They are fighting, like he ends up invading her spaceship and they end up like fighting in battle, and they both like are fighting so much that they don't realize that they are both in an escape pod like while they're fighting on the ship, and the space pod ends up being released and like gets like crashes on this planet that's below them, and it may or may not be a planet that has toxins in the air to where like if you're not constantly doing something, like, you will be in immense pain. And so, like, these people who hate each other and have, like, sworn to hate the other throughout their whole lives and have basically been trained in their brain to hate this person, like, they have to use each other to survive on this planet. It is quite interesting, quite entertaining. I found it to be like just like so much fun. It's a fun read. The rest of the series are pretty fun too. I've only read up to book two, and that one is also like enemies hate to love as well. Then we have The High Woman by Kerrigan Byrne. This is a historical romance if you cannot tell. So this one's about Dorian and Farah. And so Farah, when she was a little girl, she and her like crush when she was little, they end up doing this marriage ceremony out in the they're in Scotland, right? Yes, Scotland, out in Scotland. And like a marriage in Scotland back then is quite different than what it is now. You just exchange vows and everything. You don't need a priest or anything there. And so technically she's married when she's a little girl. Something happens to this boy to where he is taken away, and she was told that he ended up dying. And so she has said that she has been a widow her whole life. This book starts out with her years later. She's a grown woman and she now works for, I believe, Scotland Yard. And they're trying to find Dorian Blackwell, who is this like notoriously known like crime dude. They're trying to convict him of something, and Dorian ends up kidnapping Farah and taking her to his like castle and just like keeping her there, I believe for a specific reason. I don't remember the reason. It's been a while since I've read this, but she, I believe it's only takes place in her perspective, like her point of view, so we don't really get his point of view, so I don't really know his feelings throughout this, but she obviously hates him. He's like notoriously known for being the villain, like all throughout Scotland, like a huge villain, and he kidnaps her And so of course she hates it. And I just love the little like twist in here. I saw it coming, but like I loved it in here. And just like the dynamic between the two is amazing. I really enjoyed this one. And the cover honestly just gets me every time. Like, look at that. Amazing, beautiful. Then we have The Gravity of Us by Brittany C. Cherry. This one is a grumpy sunshine romance as well. So our book starts out with our hero. He was married. His wife left him and his maybe month-year-old, not even month-year-old, baby daughter ends up abandoning them. And our heroine works, I believe, at a flower shop. Like, she knows him. I can't tell you how she knows him, but she knows this man and knows how he's struggling, and he really needs help taking care of his daughter. And he's also a very popular author. And so while he's writing, he needs somebody to like help take care of his baby. And so she comes over every day to like help him, even though he wishes he didn't need the help. And he's very gruff, very grumpy, and rude. Very rude to her. Even though he knows deep down that he needs the help, he doesn't want to ask for it. He doesn't want to be the type of person to ask for it. And our heroine, she does not like how rude and grumpy he is, but she is a super, super sunshine. She wears her heart on her sleeve. I love their dynamic so much, and they learn how to, like, despite not liking each other at the beginning, because he can't stand how cheery and sunshiny she is in a world he has described to be quite brutal and hard. Like, he can't stand how she is like so positive all the time. And she just wishes that he could look on the bright side of things. And they both have gone through quite a lot. And so they both like form this relationship through taking care of this baby and loving this baby. And oh my word, this book is so spoonworthy, very emotional. Brittany C. Cherry does not disappoint when it comes to emotional reads. Then I have Well Met by Jen DeLuca. This is a romance that takes place in a Renaissance festival, which was an amazing book for me because I grew up and still go to Ren fairs. I love Ren fairs so much. The atmosphere is just magical and amazing, and I felt like you could feel that in this book, and I loved that. So Emily here, she has to be a part of this Ren fair because her niece wants to be in it. Emily's sister has been injured recently, and she can't go and help her daughter, and so she asks Emily to come help her with this Ren fair thing. So basically, Emily's niece wants to be in this Ren fair, but you need adult supervision if you're not over the age of 18. You need an adult to also work with you in this Ren fair. And so Emily steps up to the plate. She decides to help her niece out in this Ren fair and participate in it. And so she has to be a bar wench. And the whole person running the Ren fair is Simon. He came up with it. He's been running it for years. And he is super, super gruff, standoffish, and mean to Emily from the beginning. They do not get along at all. She can't stand him, he can't stand her. But then when they're in the Ren fair, she has to play this bar wench character, and he is a pirate. And they have a romance while like their characters, like through the characters they have a romance. And whoa, I loved that so much. I just kept picturing him as Captain Jack Sparrow, and I love Captain Jack Sparrow, so. Again, I love the relationship between the two of them because of their relationship, like, as, like, characters, like, pretending to be these certain characters. You can see them start to, like, or specifically her, because I think it's only in her point of view, like, her feelings start to shift towards him, and I love, like, how complicated, like, he's making her feel. She's like, he's like this in real life, but then he's acting this way towards me as a character. Like, is that the way he feels about me? Like, what is going on? And I honestly loved her confusion, because I was confused too. I love just reading this and going through Emily's journey of figuring out if this man actually hates her or not. Then I have Cold Hearted Rake by Lisa Kleypas. Now, I think this one's kind of a bit of a stretch, maybe, for hate to love. It's been quite a while since I read this. Oh, here is the step back. Very pretty. I love her dress. This book is the first book in the Ravenels, and you have to read this one to get to the rest of them. The rest of them are complete gems. Five star amazing. So many of them are five star amazing. This one is definitely my least favorite in the series, or close second. I didn't really enjoy book number, what book number is it? Book number four. Number four and this one are the only two I did not give five stars to. This one's about Devin. He was the cousin to an Earl who just died. Before he died, he got married a couple days before he died, this Earl. And so Devin is now in charge of this estate, as well as the past Earl's many sisters and his wife, his widow, named Kathleen. And Kathleen does not like Devin right off the bat, and Devin does not like her right off the bat. She wants him to take care of this estate. She wants to stay in this estate with these sisters because they've grown to love it. They've lived there their whole lives, and they just wouldn't know what to do without this house, this beautiful house, and the people within the house. And Devin just wants to sell it and not get rid of it. He wants nothing to do with being an earl, like nothing. He just wants to get on with his life. He just wants the money and wants to leave. So both of them don't like each other because they're both fighting for different things. You can totally see them grow to love one another though. Even though it's not as believable to me as some of the other ones in here, this one is a hate to love. They both despise each other at the beginning of this book. It's not my favorite thing in the world, but you have to read it to go on with the Ravenels, and the rest of them are just complete gems. I love them. So this does have hate to love in it, but it's not necessarily my favorite thing ever. And lastly on this list, we have The Winter King by C.L. Wilson. I love this book so much. This is a fantasy romance book. The cover isn't the best thing in the world, you know? you would probably think that it's a historical, but this is in fact a fantasy romance. This is about Winter and what's her name? Casmin. Winter and Casmin. And Winter is the Winter King. This book also involves a land where there are people have magical powers, specifically weather-related powers. So Winter here is the Winter King, and he can collect, he can control, he has winter magic, there you go, like snow, stuff like that. And he's quite powerful, and he really wants to get back at the King of Summerlee. And so to do that, he has told the King of Summerlee, if you don't let me marry your most beautiful daughter, I'm gonna invade and take over your land. And the King of Summerlee is like, oh no, I love all of my daughters so much, except for one. His daughters are notoriously known for being one of the most beautiful women in the land, but he has kept one of his daughters a secret, and that is Casmin. Casmin has never left the castle, never left her tower, and so he decides he's going to trick Winter, trick him, and have him marry Casmin so that he can keep all of the daughters he loves and adores. Without Winter knowing it, he marries Casmin, who is not one of the famous daughters of Summerlee, but it is still one of the king's daughters, and she has storm magic. And it is a hate to love between the two because he thinks that she tricked him. She just hates him in general, but he's quite gruff and abrasive and mean at times, and she just can't stand it. It is definitely hate to love between the two of them. I love their dynamic of how you can see them just grow to adore one another and love each other and need each other. Like, they fully need one another in this world. Like, they can't live without each other at the end. And oh my word, I loved the growth. Beautiful, amazing, one of my favorite books of all time. So there you have it. Those are some hate to love romance recommendations for you. I have many other books that have this trope in them. These are just 10 that I have. So let me know if you want a part 2 or even a part 3 to this video. But yes, please let me know down below if you've read any of these books or if you plan to. But anyways, thank y'all so much for watching. I will see y'all soon in my next one. Bye y'all.